Syria may be off the front pages, but the situation there is
terrible.
It's awful. Dire, yeah. We have the Defense Secretary Ash Carter in Brussels convening leaders there tomorrow, including Arab states, asking them to do more. They say that we need more U.S. leadership, that we should commit U.S. ground troops. Should we commit U.S. ground troops?
Well, you know, Syria is a whole different thing. And you look at what's happening. I view ISIS as very important. And I love the fact that Russia is hitting ISIS. And as far as I'm concerned, they've got to continue to hit ISIS.
But you know what Russia is doing in Syria? Russia is hitting,
hitting
the
both.
Groups that we're backing.
Sure. And why are we backing the group? We don't even know who those people are. I speak to generals. They're saying we're giving billions of dollars of equipment to people we have no. Here we go again. Yeah. We're giving all of this money and all of this equipment to people we have no idea who they are. They're probably worse than Assad. I mean, Assad's no baby. He's not good. But who are the people that we're backing? Here we go again with Libya.
That's President Obama's argument.
Yeah.
Well,
we don't know
good.
Who the weapons will fall into whose hands.
We have no idea. Well, why is he doing that, though? I mean, he's giving them a lot of weaponry, and we're backing people that want to knock out Assad. Russia and Iran, which is now a power, we've made them a power, they're backing Assad. We've got to get rid of ISIS. We've got to get rid of the people that are chopping off everybody's head.
You say you have a good relationship with Putin or would have a good relationship?
I would have a very good relationship, but who knows?
So could you convince Putin to get Assad to step aside?
Well, they've been trying to do that. Yeah. Could I? I don't think it's that important, to be honest with you. I think, frankly, let's say you get rid of Assad or you knock out that government. Who's going to take over? The people that were backing, and then you're going to have, like, Libya, right? You take Gaddafi. Oh, we have to get rid of Gaddafi. Look what happened after we got rid of Gaddafi. Look what happened after we got rid of Saddam.
So getting rid of Gaddafi was a mistake.
It was just, yeah, it was a total mistake. I mean, Benghazi was the least. Look at what's going on over there. It's a mess. Nobody knows anything about anything. You look at Saddam Hussein. We get rid of Saddam Hussein. The terrorists, it's the Harvard
so
of terrorists.
So getting rid of Gaddafi and getting rid of Saddam Hussein were both mistakes.
Had we not done anything, had our politicians gone to the beach and enjoyed the sun, we would be in a lot better position than we are right now. Saddam Hussein, no good guy, but Saddam Hussein killed terrorists. Now Iraq is the Harvard of terror. You want to become a terrorist, go to Iraq. They'll teach you how, okay? Mm-hmm. Saddam Hussein was a bad guy. But, you know, one other thing he did, he blocked Iran. I mean, once you knocked out that section, all of us, and I said it in 2003, 2004, I was against the war. I said, you're going to have the Middle East is going to be a mess. They used to fight forever. They couldn't move. They'd go 10 feet one way, 10 feet the other. Now you have a total destabilization in the Middle East because we knocked out one of the blocks.
What's the difference in your appeal and Bernard Sanders' appeal, because they both are appealing to arguments, they seem to be receptive arguments against the establishment?
Well, I think I am a little bit against the establishment, and he probably is also. I tell you, the one thing we have in common is trade. The only difference is he can't do anything about it. I can. He knows that China's ripping us, and he admits it, and he knows Japan and Vietnam, that's the new one on the block, by the way, they're ripping us big league in Mexico, and I do too. The difference is I can do something about it. I will take those deals and make them
great. It's
great
to have you here.
Yes, thank you,
Donald. Nice to be with you, Charlie.
We hope that you'll return.
Yes, come back.
I will.
You'll return.
I will. I'd love to do it by phone. I mean, if you have your phoners.
No, no, no.
How about some phoners?
It's good to see you in person.
Charlie, it's great to hear you.
We want you to get dressed and out of your pajamas and come.
I'll be back.
We'll see you at the debate on Saturday night.
Good.
As well.
I look forward to it.